Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Sunday of the 10th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is a stronghold of my life. Whom should I dread? When those who do evil draw near, they stumble and fall.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call on you in our need may at your prompting discern what is right, and by your guidance do it. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. First reading, a reading from the book of Genesis. After the man, Adam, had eaten of the tree, the Lord God called to the man and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked, "Who told you that you were naked? You have eaten, then, from the tree of which I had forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman whom you put here with me, she gave me fruit from the tree, and so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "Why did you do such a thing?" The woman answered, "The serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head, while you strike at his heel." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to my voice in supplication.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
If you, O Lord, mark iniquities, Lord, who can stand? But with you is forgiveness, that you may be revered.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
I trust in the Lord, my soul trusts in his word. More than sentinels wait for the dawn, let Israel wait for the Lord.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
For with the Lord is kindness, and with him is plenteous redemption, and he will redeem Israel from all their iniquities.
With the Lord there is mercy and fullness of redemption.
Second reading. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what is written, "I believed, therefore I spoke." We too believe, and therefore we speak, knowing that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more and more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. Therefore, we are not discouraged. Rather, although our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day. For this momentary light, affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to what is seen, but to what is unseen. For what is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. For we know that if our earthly dwelling, a tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia. Now the ruler of the world would be driven out, says the Lord. And when I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw everyone to myself. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came home with his disciples, and again the crowd gathered, making it impossible for them even to eat. When his relatives heard of this, they set out to seize him, for they said, "He is out of his mind." The scribes who had come from Jerusalem said, "He is possessed by Beelzebul, and by the prince of demons he drives out demons." Summoning them, he began to speak to them in parables. How can Satan drive out Satan? If a kingdom is divided against itself, that kingdom cannot stand. And if a house is divided against itself, that house will not be able to stand. And if Satan is risen up against himself and is divided, he cannot stand. That is the end of him. But no one can enter a strong man's house to plunder his property unless he first ties up the strong man. Then he can plunder the house. Amen, I say to you, all sins and all blasphemies that people utter will be forgiven them. But whoever blasphemes against the Holy Spirit will never have forgiveness, but is guilty of an everlasting sin. For they had said, "He has an unclean spirit." His mother and his brothers arrived. Standing outside, they sent word to him and called him. A crowd seated around him told him, "Your mother and your brothers and your sisters are outside asking for you." But he said to them in reply, "Who are my mother and my brothers?" And looking around at those seated in the circle, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers, for whoever does the will of God is my brother and sister and mother." My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now today we have a very interesting gospel, in the sense that if you notice, the middle part is almost like a string of different thoughts, you know. So, but let me just invite you to focus on three things, no? Almost also somewhat disjoint, you know. But first is the skepticism that Jesus faced, no, with his family and the scribes, no, the skepticism that met the message and the work and ministry of Jesus, no. And then second is to take a look at the whole section on exorcism, no, of expelling demons, no. And then the last one is that I'd like to take a look at what the Lord says, "This is my family, no, this is my mother, this is my brother, my sister, no." So first about the skepticism, no. Clearly, no, when as the gospel opens, it says that his relative said he is out of his mind, no. And then the scribes accused him, no, of using the power of the devil, the evil spirit, to cast out an evil spirit, no. So here you realize that this is always, in a sense, a burden or a trial that someone who has, in a sense, a very pioneering message, a very different message, or a very different lifestyle. This is what people with such, you might say, paths or vocations in life face, no? For example, you have many, many stories of people who enter the seminary, and sometimes the family is against it. So they could really think that, try to do everything, no, to derail that vocation, so to speak, no? You know, but there is such a thing, no? even now, no, that when people do not fully understand what one is trying to do, one would cast doubts or even be skeptical about what one wants to do, no? So I think that is something that I invite you to reflect on, because most certainly this is a challenge, no? Especially if one is doing something radically different, no? There's always that skepticism, the misunderstanding for people who trailblaze, no? And people would always dismiss it, oh, that's just some foolish dreaming, no, etc., no? But that is what the Lord faced, no? From his own family and from the religious authorities most especially, no? Because there you have a mix of motivation, so to speak, no? So, but maybe that first point to reflect and to ask ourselves, no, did we ever get into that situation wherein people were skeptical of what we wanted to do? People would say, oh, it can never be done, no? And I think each and every one of us has that's some sort of experience, no? Some more profound than others, no? I think we do experience that, no? So that first point to reflect on, no? And then the second point is that the exorcism here, I think what I want to emphasize, no, is that, you know, you realize that from the very beginning, the ministry of Christ included the battle between good and evil, no? So clearly the people then, no, believed in evil spirits. That's why a lot of people came to have their friends or relatives exorcised, no? But I think what I want to highlight here is that there is the theme of the battle between good and evil. Remember that we mentioned this, no, that the very beginning of the ministry of the Lord, especially in the Gospel of Luke, he emphasizes that part of his ministry is to engage in that ongoing battle between good and evil. And even to this day, no, there is that battle between good and evil. That's why exorcism then was a very normal thing for people to do, no? And I think now more and more, I think as from what I hear, no, more and more people are also turning to exorcists, no? I mean, the official exorcists, no, of each diocese would have one, no? But I think what I want to invite you to reflect on is to realize that there is that battle between good and evil. And I think that's why we need to strengthen our own fiber of goodness, if you wish, no? Our own character of goodness to engage in that battle, no? And then the third and last point is, and for me, again, a very beautiful reminder, no? When the Lord simply says, no, who are my brothers and sisters? For me, that's such a powerful moment, no? When he simply points out to the people around him, to the people who are seeking to understand God's word, and therefore people who are searching, no, perhaps to know what God's word and God's will is. And as the Lord said, whoever hears the word of my Father and follows, no, again, you go back to obedience. You go back to loving obedience. That is what will bring us together as brothers and sisters. Excuse me. And I think one important element here in this gospel is that when he points to the people around him, he also reminds us that, no, because we have a shared experience, we're searching, no, for the same grace, no, and that is what makes us brothers and sisters. Siguro itong ebanghelyo ngayong linggo, no, parang ano, medyo utay-utay siya, no, hindi siya ganung kalinaw yung kwento, no, yung naratibo, no. Pero siguro tatlong punto na pwede natin pagnilayan. Una sa lahat, pag ang tao may ginagawang kakaiba, may tinatahak na ibang bokasyon, kadalasan ano siya, pinagdududahan, hindi siya pinaniniwalaan ng mga tao. Pero ito yung naranasan ng Panginoon, no? Medyo skeptical yung kanyang mga kamag-anak at yung mga skriba, no? Kaya siguro makikita natin to, bahagi ito ng pagsunod sa Panginoon. Kung minsan hindi tayo agad mauunawaan, ano, ng sarili natin mga pamilya. Bahagi yan ng ano, bahagi yan ng pagsasagawa ng isang bagay na kakaiba, bagay na talagang masasabi ng radical, no? Mahalaga na maunawaan natin na dumaan ang Panginoon doon, ano? Tapos yung pangalawang punto ay yung ditong magandang tema ito, no? Lagi itong makikita sa tema ng Panginoon na merong patuloy na pagtutunggali ang kabutihan at kasamaan sa mundo. At ito ay sinasabi ng Panginoon, no? Tandaan natin mga tao naniniwala sa exorcism, no? Dahil bahagi ito ng ministro ng pagtatrabaho ng Panginoon, no? Ng kanyang paglilingkod. At ito'y nagpapahiwatig na hanggang ngayon, meron niyang patuloy na pagtutunggali ng kabutihan at kasamaan. At yung pangatlo, tuling punto na napakahalagang punto, pinapakita ng Panginoon, sino ba ang aking mga kapatid, ang aking mga ina, ama, yung mga taong sumusunod sa kagustuhan ng Diyos. Balik tayo dun sa mapagmahal na pagtalima. Yun ang nagbubuklod sa atin bilang isang pamilya. So today let us reflect on the lessons or the points of this gospel, no? And especially looking at it as what brings us together as brothers and sisters under one fatherhood of God, under one family, is obedience. Obedience to the Father's will, and that obedience is in following Christ, no? So today let us pray for that, no, as we continue our Mass. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified and died and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, in the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Mindful of Jesus' identification of his family as those who follow the will of God, let us pray to our Heavenly Father that we too may have faith in his Son and resolve to do what is pleasing to him. For every petition we pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
May the Church, with its clergy and servants, proclaim the gospel with priceless joy and unwavering faith. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May government officials be aware of their intrinsic ties to the people they serve and avoid enacting laws which are detrimental to human life and dignity. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May religious men and women heed the call to renew their vows, not only in ritual, but more importantly in faithful witness to the one to whom they have consecrated their lives. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we pray most especially for the good health of the Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray for all of his intentions, especially for his prayers for peace. Let's also continue to pray for rain, that the Lord may also, you know, lower the temperatures. And let's also pray that the Lord may send rain to avert any power or water shortages. Again, we continue to pray for our brothers and sisters affected by Mount Canlaon. And let's also continue to pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer may be an acceptable oblation to you, and lead us to grow in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you," Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Yes. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
God, our loving Father, creator of our earth and of the universe, we humbly ask you to grant us relief from the extreme heat that besets your people, disrupting our activities and threatening our lives and livelihood. Send us rain to replenish our depleting water sources, to irrigate our fields, to stave off water and power shortages, and to provide water for our daily needs. Raise your hand, Almighty God, to avert the continuing rise in temperatures so that your people can engage in productive undertakings, especially our youth in their studies. Merciful and generous God, instill in us a deep love for this earth. Teach us to be wise stewards of your creation, so that we may always use them responsibly. At this time of crisis, dear Lord, move us to share more, to serve more, and to love more. Loving God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you entrusted the Filipino people to the special care of Mary, our Mother. Listen to the prayers that we bring up to her, our Blessed Mother. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our Lady of Guadalupe,
pray for us.
Saint Rose of Lima,
pray for us.
Saints Lorenzo Ruiz and Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us. And let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil and lead us to what is right, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat for joining us. And again, after this, please join us for Journeys of Hope. And we will talk about Caritas Philippines, no? And my work as my new work as executive director of Caritas Philippines. And then also for Proyecto Filipino, a very good discussion on independence, on kalayaan as we observe Independence Day this coming Wednesday. Then also for that our collection so far for as of this week, we have 8,047,478 pesos and 1 centavo. Again, please continue to support Ale Kapwa and also the Ale Kapwa Expanded Program. So maraming pong salamat and have a good and prayerful and restful Sunday ahead. Thank you po.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.